And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later on over there for some mono green Tron to kick the day off today. As you can see here, we got four new fun decks to try out. These were all decks that had some results online. None of these decks were ones that I made. This one here was from the Arena qualifier, the Mythic Championship qualifier this past weekend on Arena. This was a day two deck. So I wanted to give it a try. So if you're not very familiar with what Tron means with the mono green Tron, that is referring to a modern deck that's built around the Urza's lands. And the payoff of those Urza lands in modern is casting Karn Liberated very early. This deck is not really like it too much. Basically the reason why this deck is like it though, the things it has in common is like one of our main payoffs here is Karn. So, you know, we just have another Karn deck here, and we're also trying to get a whole bunch of mana. That's what like our deck's trying to do. And the Urza lands in modern get you a whole lot of mana. And that's what Nissa does here with all these forests. So mono green Tron is a modern deck. And so it's just kind of calling this mono green Tron as well. It's fun to say it's more better than like mono green, you know, ramp or whatever. Ugin is also a planeswalker in the Tron deck. So we're a Karn Ugin deck. And it's mono green, and so that's what we have here. But yeah, we got Karn the Great Creator. So we've played this in Best of One. We played a version like this in Best of One. This will be our first time trying it in Best of Three. In Best of One, it's really nice to have access to a sideboard with the -2 ability of Karn the Great Creator. In Best of Three, though, that takes up a lot of sideboard slots to have a bunch of artifacts, and then you don't really have a lot of stuff for other things. We have one God Pharaoh statue, one Meteor Golem as our main things that we're going to be getting with the -2, and then we also have like a removal spell with Silent Dart, the Gravestone for the Dreadhorde decks, and another Crucible of Worlds, because I think that's going to be like a main thing of our deck is trying to get Field of Ruin, Crucible of Worlds online against these 3 and 4 colored decks. But this one looks pretty exciting to play. I like all these Ripjaw Raptors against mono red. I think that's a good plan. So yeah, let's give it a try. Let's go ahead and mono green Tron it up in best of three. Yeah, that's a good point. The Explore package was just took too much room to play a Boreal Grazer. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, we could have turn 2 Field of Ruin with we could have turn 1 Land War Elf, turn 2 Field, activate it, play another Land War Elf. No lands. Oh, are we on the... How do we know if we're on the play or the draw? I guess it doesn't tell you. I think I'm on the play. Tilt, I'm on the draw? Dang it. Gates? Well, Gates has been pretty bad against Field of Ruin in general. I kind of wanted just to play the Branch Walker here, honestly. Man, what is going on here with this mana base? If we draw another land, I'm probably just going to go Field of Ruin plus Bond of Flourishing. We don't have another land, though, so we're going Jade Light Ranger. That's sad, getting rid of that Crucible. Crucible Field of Ruin would definitely be what we want to be doing. We just need more mana, though. Hey, Luffy. Welcome from Switzerland over here. If it's orange, the arrow at the bottom of the right tells you. If it's blue, they go first. If it's orange, you go first. Oh. Interesting. There are some lands. Well, we are at 35. We can probably attack in. So this gives their creature +1/+0 for each gate and has vigilance and menace. Well, Ram already has vigilance. Well, that's unfortunate. So they only have one land that can actually cast the Gatebreaker Ram. Let's blow that up. Dang, they have a forest. Consider Field of Ruining again. Yeah, we have Blast Zone and Field of Ruins in here. Bad Ram. Right, Ugin making the colorless spells. I forgot about the whole make your colorless spells cost two less. Next turn we can Karn. Go grab Crucible, play Crucible, start Field of Ruining. No. Well, that was the plan. I mean, I can still do that. Or I can play Ugin and start ticking up. I think I'm just going to play Ugin. Well. Never mind. Even this Crucible. All right, there's the Angel. Blast Zone is tapped though, so let's destroy the Blast Zone right now while it's tapped. One, two, three, four, man. This deck's sweet.
Your past is unwritten.
My grief proved my mission.
Be wary of the ground you walk on.
All right, we'll make their spells cost more. And blow up this interplanar beacon, I suppose. Yeah, Mono Green Tron's a lot of fun. Get to just field of ruin every turn for the rest of the game. I kind of wish we had a Sword Tooth so we could play two Field of Ruins a turn. So we saw them have Time Wipe, which is why I didn't like play the other Land War Elf out. Honestly, don't think we sideboard. Honestly, I think we keep these things in the sideboard to be able to grab with Karn. And I don't know if we do any. I guess maybe we play Vivian. Nah, we don't even need Vivian. Yeah, I feel like we don't sideboard. Vivian would go in for what? For like a Wild Growth Walker? To be able to destroy. They have the blue gate enchantment, which I'm sure they have. Destroy that. Bum, bum. I think Vivian's like the only card that I'm considering, and I think it'd be for a Wild Growth Walker. Now I'm gonna just take out the Adventurous Impulse. Just gonna do that. And what's up, Morgan? Yeah, we're playing Tron. So yeah, this specific list was not one that I put together. But I think I would like a copy of Immortal Sun against like the Planeswalker decks, even though we are pretty reliant on our Nissa and Ugin. Immortal Sun is just so powerful against the right deck. Got new sleeves. So I'm gonna try to be able to go Wild Growth into then Branch Walker, Jade Light kind of thing. Hopefully draw some lands. Hopefully. Maybe I should just go the safer route and cast the bond to hit a land drop. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Just a safer thing to do. So I certainly want a Jaylai Ranger. And their mana base is something else. That's a good card. Card that ties everything together. Circuitous Route. So we have seen sweepers from them. I guess we are attacking them down to 8. I probably don't need to play anything else. Yeah. Go, Ugin, go.
My presence alone will guide. Truth lies beyond vision.
Field of Ruin would definitely be nice to find with these Crucible Worlds. Gain 10. Casually. Alright. So, if you cost 2, I would have 5 mana left.
Until you have lived as a statue, do not talk to me of pigeons. True goodness will never be corrupted.
Gonna go this way so we can continue to plus Ugin instead of minusing the Ugin to take that out. We have a lot of lands that we're going to have to fight through here with this Field of Ruin. Maybe too many. Alright, what are you going to do, Karn?
Stand down!
I mean, it's just grab God Pharaoh statue. That one life a turn can add up. That's fine. No big deal.
Secrets manifest before you.
I guess I could have played the other Crucible too. Oh yeah, I think these Ugin creatures are just beaten down. For sure, and we'll be able to tick up on Karn next turn, make the Crucible a 3/3. Whoa, not cool. Not cool.
The fabric of the multiverse obeys me.
There is great power in the thing you make.
It's not good. I mean, it should just be that I get all these things back, right?
We will not fail. Harness the elements.
Well, I would get the Jade Light back. Yeah, Nissa was great.
I battle for the forces of good. My allies are counting on me.
Arcane Encyclopedia. I don't know, do I just say that thing? Nah, I gotta say Ugin. Yeah, we gotta say Ugin to protect Nissa. Yep. Tristani only gets your creatures back, so they would still keep Karn and Ugin. I need to go grab the other spyglass for this encyclopedia now. Interesting. Then it just like activate encyclopedia during their turn or anything?
My purpose is greater than myself.
Wait, was I just supposed to tick up? Yeah, I was supposed to just tick up. Why can't they use Encyclopedia? Oh! Because Karn. Karn has text. Right. Right, Karn's text. They can't use either of these. Oh, well. Right. That's not text that I've ever encountered mattering before. The text I'm referring to is activate abilities of artifacts your opponents control can't be activated. So they can't activate those. I was wondering, I was like, why didn't they just... Like, if they're going to attack with their 3-3, why don't they even equip the sword and that kind of stuff? And, you know, they just can't. All right, want to know. Starting the day off with a win. This deck's pretty fun. Like, Nissa, Karn, and Ugin are all fun cards, especially Karn and Ugin. And then Nissa just gives you all the mana to be able to use Karn and Ugin. Yeah, I wasn't expecting... Yeah, like, that passive ability on Karn doesn't matter too much, like, too often here in Standard. It matters a lot more in other formats. All right, let's go ahead and keep. Got a lot of lands. Ooh. Yeah, Rex, 5-color Niv-Mizzet and paper. Do it. If you need to make a couple budget, changes, like that's, you can do that. Nothing wrong with that. Yeah, Mardu Feather looks pretty sweet. That was just a deck in the 5-0 list today. I was looking on there and I was like, ooh, that looks fun. It's basically just Boros Feather with, you know, Dreadhorde Arcanist and Feather the Redeemed, but then uses black for Sorin that can get them back. So like if they kill either of your important creatures, you can play Sorin and minus and get those creatures back immediately. No, I've not gotten my 15 wins in that event yet. No, I've gotten like 9 or 8 or 9. I know that's ending here pretty soon, so I'm going to be playing that event more after stream, like tonight, so I can work towards that Jace. So this is a tough call. I have one Nissa already. I can go Library, though. Like, they're a deck that probably is going to be, like, interacting a bunch, maybe killing my Nissa. I want another one. No, Anox. I do a lot of deck building myself as well. I just haven't in the past week. Too much, but no, this is the first time in months that I've been playing just some decks from online, honestly. Almost always just design my own decks, but evil must not be tolerated. Saw some decks that look pretty interesting that I wanted to try. So I guess my plan next turn is to be able to play Nissa, Tick Up, play Spyglass, name whatever they have, like Vivian or whatever. I mean, they just kill Jade Light, then they get to kill Karn. That's not ideal. I don't really like where we're at. I don't feel too good about where we're at in this game. Do have a backup Nissa, even if they have another explore creature and can kill the Nissa here. We have the backup. Still getting to play this though. This is awkward. That's awkward. I'm gonna name Nissa. So that they don't just like play their own Nissa that kills mine. Like if I don't name Nissa, they play their own, kill mine, and then I'm just gonna be like really far behind. Like my other Nissa's not even gonna really be able to kill theirs, and it's just gonna be a huge problem for me. Jade Light's a good draw. That means I get to kill Nissa. So basically, I was just gonna take out there too, and hope that my mind with the passive ability was going to do some work for me. Hey, what's up, Valoraxial?
Fight on without me.
Ugh. Ugins. Yeah, it's in there, Rex. Somewhere. It's usually easier to find them on YouTube, so I'll just go to the YouTube channel and just kind of hit the videos and scroll down and look for Niv-Mizzet pictures. What's in there somewhere? Here we go. And welcome... So while Blast Zone on 2 would be nice to get rid of Hydroid Crisis and Wild Growth Walker, I can't really do that because of the Spyglass. I think I'm just kind of dead. Both playing like the same kind of cards, but they had just a lot better hands. Can't really see anything that I am excited to do here with sideboarding. Do I want to, like, take out some of my Nissas and try to spyglass their Nissa? But then, like, what am I really doing then? I'm guessing with Karn I should have grabbed, like, the statue or the golem. But we were still, if I would have done that, they would have just grabbed a bunch of Nissas and killed me. I was in a rough spot. Yeah, Ripjaw's a blocker. As we saw there, they have a lot of cast downs, like a lot of removal spells that kill Ripjaw very easily. I assume they're playing like Chupacabra or Hostage Taker, and Raptor just doesn't match up against those cards well at all. Matches up really bad against them. I think these other artifacts, I'm just going to have them still in the sideboard for Karn. I could see Silent Gravestone doing some work for us if they are playing Find Finality or Command the Dreadhorde, but I'm just going to keep it in the sideboard to like grab with Karn. This is better. So like last time I just didn't have anything... Really, I mean, I had one Jade Light before Karn, and they killed the Jade Light, and then I just didn't have blockers. And hopefully I have a little bit more blockers here. No, that's correct. Our deck doesn't really have a good sideboard. This is a fun deck, though. Hey, Zoe. Efficient creatures that pressure you and give you card advantage is what we're going to struggle against. And that's what our opponent had that last game with those Wild Growth into Jade Light. That's pretty tough for us to deal with. So I'm shuffling away that duress here. Even though we're not playing anything else this turn, we're just getting that duress out of there. And who knows, maybe that was their only blue source. Tilt. They had another dress. Ooh, the Crucible Worlds. Didn't want me rebuying that Field of Ruin. It's good to play this before you explore. So we're doing that. No, our opponent isn't going to be playing islands. They're going to have a few forests and maybe a swamp or two. I guess it'd probably be like two forests, one swamp, something like that. Something in that ballpark. You know, maybe an extra forest or swamp, but I don't think that there's any islands at all. All right, well, this definitely is counter magic. It could be contempt also. But most likely counter magic. Ooh, alright, it's contempt.
What a strange and magnificent world.
Do I want to land to be a 3-3? Yes, I do.
Behold, nature's true power.
Wait. Yeah. I knew there was a reason why I wanted that land to be a 3-3. It doesn't matter which, if you play the revealed land, or like, we had two lands revealed. It just checks art. Like, if you have two of the same card, it just checks what art. So yeah, we had two forests that were revealed last time. No, my Ugin. What? They took Karn? Really? Interesting. Well, what's your plan here for this?
Do not defy the designs. The truth lies beyond vision.
The land shall conquer you.
I don't think our opponent's playing any Mystic Snakes in their deck. This is not a Mystic Snake deck.
Ether itself serves me.
The land fights for us.
Ritual of Soot is a little surprising.
We are but motes in a vast multiverse. My plans do not include you. Secrets manifest before you.
I don't want to just use a blast zone on a land war elf, right?
Petty squabbling.
Nah. putting one counter on there because of like Hydro Crisis. And
I will fight with honor.
Wild Growth Walker. Alright, Field of Ruin, Crucible time. Let's see how many basics you got over there.
The fabric of the multiverse obeys me.
There's a second forest, third forest. Is it like three forests, one swamp or so? And there is a Crisis. I got that Blast Zone on too to take care of that. Well, first we're going to do this. I, of course, can minus the Ugin to take care of that as well. Which I guess I'm going to do here. Four forests, huh? I guess because they're playing Nissa. Start draining them out with the statue. One life.
Through this land, we are all connected. Rise, my elemental friend.
Ow.
I will return.
You have erred. Truth lies beyond vision.
Unfortunately, of course, we can't blow up the basic forest. You can only destroy non-basic lands with Field of Ruin. Getting all those Field of Ruins. So yeah, we'll attack him down to 3, because then God Pharaoh Statue puts him down to 2. No, Ugin can't destroy land, no. Ugin can only destroy things that are colored. It can destroy colored permanents. Lands are colorless, so no. Can't do that. Yeah, I'm going to play a Ripjaw over one of the Crucibles. Maybe I do that over the other one too, honestly. We do have a lot of forests they get to go grab. Crucible's only good if we have Field of Ruin, and plus we have the Karns that can go find Crucible. Let's do that. Let's put a couple of Ripjaws in here on the draw. I guess I don't know. I didn't think that Nissa made the creatures green elementals, but maybe Nissa does, honestly. Yeah, honestly, that could be. Let's look at the text for Nissa here. No, it's not green element. Nope. It's just a 0/0 elemental creature. Nope. Does not make it a green creature. Nope, keeps it colorless. Well, this is a good opener for us to have. If I could, like, pick an opener, this would be in our top. This is probably like a top 10% of opener for us. Problem is, of course, they have a lot more removal. We're doing like the same kind of stuff, but they have cast downs and other removal spells, and I don't. So theirs looks pretty good too with Land of War into WoW growth. Ooh. Alright, not killing the wild growth. Interesting. Don't want to double spell or play Jade Light in single spell. Bunch of walkers. Attack. 41. It's a good life total. Nissa.
Power surges through these lands. Be wary of the ground you walk on.
The last game we took over with Ugin, the last game. If they block Land of War Elves, then they have to block. Yeah, this is just all going at them. The only way for them to kill Land of War Elf is to double chump block the Wild Growth Walkers, and that still puts them down to one. And now they can't gain life without having the Wild Growth Walkers. All right. Yeah, the game was pretty similar to the game one, where game one our opponent had WoW Growth, Jade Light, and I got ran over, and this time I had the two WoW Growths and Jade Lights and just ran our opponent over. We did see them have the Ritual of Soot game two, so that was like their out basically, was if they had another Ritual of Soot. So you can tell I wasn't really playing around it, I was trying to end the game quickly. Yep. Call it Tron because of Karn. Karn, Ugin, a bunch of mana. You know, big mana deck with Nissa and has Karn and Ugin at the top end. So yeah, that's why we're calling it Tron. My regrets are few. Air Canada. Mono red. Mono red means we're mono dead. Steamkin. Well, let's impulse. You know, we're looking for WoW growth. Walker here. Yeah, I'll play Branchwalker. Considering playing Bond of Flourishing, it's a good card, but. We really need to find Wild Growth Walker. They did like mold a five, I think, or something like that. Like they mold a bunch. So we're not like just dead. Haven't seen Wild Growth yet. You know, it's not one of the bottom four cards. Oh no! Not Frenzy. Why does that have to be their last card? So, Karn can grab. Karn can grab like a 7 mana destroyed enchantment card. Hey Gomez. I'm playing 3 green decks today, but this is the only green deck with the Explore package in it. That's the good news. I really wish I had a way to put a counter on this blast zone here and just activate it next turn. I don't. We never drew a Wild Growth Walker either. I guess I'm going to put a counter on a blast zone here. Yeah, statue making all their cards cost you more is just too late. For right now. Like maybe later. gonna hit another land. It's just never gonna hit lands. Why is this being laggy today? Alright, we need all these Riptaw Raptors. Need the Silent Dart. I suppose. Vivian can kill an enchantment. Crucible is obviously not necessary at all. Do I just want Statue and Golem main deck and just take out Karn? And just draw these things basically instead? Because, like, spending the 4 mana to play Karn and grab something and then spending the mana to play that something is kind of rough. Like, I don't need any of those artifacts, for example. I don't need Statue either. I do want Golem. What's the last card I'm taking out here? One of the Nissas? Maybe I don't actually need Golem. We have Ugin's that destroy permanents. It is very expensive, 7 mana. Yeah, I'll take the Golem out. We don't need it. No, we just had pretty good control. So question is how is it possible that Mono Red is just always good? Mono Red hasn't always been good. It's just been good for the last, I don't know, 3-4 years. However long ago Dragons of Tarkir was. Basically that long. But there's just been, like, you know, if you just kind of think about it, like, the mono red decks, you just need, like, one or two really good, strong red cards in each set. I was certainly hoping they didn't have, you know, like, basically all they could use right there with the two cards was just Lightning Strike or Lava Runner plus Wizard's Lightning, or I guess Coil. But yeah, we're hoping to, they didn't have that, but they did. So yeah, all you need is, like, one or two really good red cards in each set, and, you know, you just kind of add them together, and boom, there you have it. The thing about playing burn spells is that they're just really versatile. I've talked about this before. You know, like playing cards like Lightning Strike. Like, Lightning Strike's good against everybody. There's not decks that where Lightning Strike's not good against. You know, you can use it to hit your opponent, hit Planeswalkers. You know, you can use it anywhere. Where if you're playing cards like Cast Down or you know, other kind of removal, it's not going to be good against everybody. So I didn't play anything because of that Lava Coil. My options this turn are either destroy Lava Runner or put more counters on Blast Zone to try to get towards, like, killing an Experimental Frenzy. I'm going to destroy the Lava Runner. Now we need land drops from the Jade Light Rangers. Wow. Well, no lands in the top three there. And we had to put Ripjaw Raptor, like one of our very best cards, in the graveyard. Alright, just whiff for a turn, whiff for a turn, draw land, draw land. Yay. Gained a bunch of life. Big Wild Growth Walker now. A lot of decks that you see are comprised of a whole bunch of cards. I need to play this. Basically, I need to look for land still because the way that I lose this from here is them playing a Frenzy, so I need to just work towards trying to get that Ugin out as fast as possible to protect myself from Frenzy, because that was like the only way I was losing that at that point. If you see a lot of like different decks, they're kind of built with like a one or two sets, you know, that have a majority of the cards that kind of work together and everything, that are like really synergized, like, you know, like the Explore package or like from Ixalan, kind of thing, or like all these planeswalker type cards that all work together with like the mana base of all these planeswalkers and stuff from like War of the Spark. And you see like decks are kind of clumped by different sets, but when you look at mono red, that's not the case. Mono red just has, you know, cards from all the different sets, because, you know, there's just a couple of cards that are real good in like each of the sets, and you know, you just kind of combine them together and you got your red deck. I do think that standard is better whenever the red deck is good, though. We haven't played where the red deck is not good in a while, but whenever you have a format where the red deck is not good, you have a very, very slow format, because then at that point, if there's not a very good red deck, you're usually just trying to keep one-upping like other mid-range decks. So it's just like what mid-range deck can go bigger than other mid-range decks, and it's just can turn into like a really slow format of really grinding each other, grinding decks out and everything, and it can get kind of tough. So Paradise Druid is a good card to play here unless they have Chain Whirler. Gonna hope they don't. That thing costs 4 to activate? Wow, what a crappy card. Wow. Love it. Of course, my plan here is to Blast Zone for 2 next turn. All right, good job, Blast Zone. Yeah, I need the forest. Hey, what's up, After Wizard? Going good. And Rev Daddy? Yeah, it's going real good today. Alright, do they have the instant speed removal? Maybe not? Dang. It's worth a try. You've been having great success today with the Abzan Angels deck that you played yesterday. That's awesome. Good. Anything that you don't like in the sideboard, or maybe anything that you like really particularly like?
Together, we will prevail.
So I want to save Ugin.
Behold, nature's true
power. Even though like Ugin tick up would be pretty good play here, I want to save Ugin to make sure that it's alive to kill a frenzy kind of thing. I don't want to like play Ugin and then they like double bolt my Ugin and then I can't deal with the frenzy. Panavia with the Twitch Prime sub. Welcome to the channel, Panavia. Thanks for resubbing there. So yeah, welcome back. Second sub of the day. This silent dart is crushing it.
Harness the elements.
All right, I'll play it. I don't know if I should be playing it, honestly. Hey, there's another Ugin. Added Baby Vraska and Tristani in the sideboard instead of the second Tyrant and something else. Okay, cool. I like those cards. I like those. I did attack. Yeah, I attacked. That's why they're at 17. All right, 3-0. We took out Mono Red, and we didn't even, like, our main sideboard card is Ripjaw Raptor. We didn't even draw any Ripjaw Raptors. That was obvious, like, honestly, that was just all about Blast Zone there. Blast Zone clearing up all those Steamkins. It's all about that, and it's about my opponent didn't, have Frenzy there. Games 2 or 3, that really helped. You don't need that. Yeah, sorry, Donahoe, I didn't send you a message today. I had another sideboard guide that I needed to make today and spent a good amount of time on that. But just look at this list. Just get Angel of Grace out of the sideboard and put Tristani in instead. So if you play against, like, the... I think playing a green-white deck like that, I definitely think you should have one Tristani in the sideboard against these mass manipulation decks that are running around. So that's a change just to make right away. But besides that, it looks pretty good.
Right on schedule.
Yeah, maybe a 4-mana of Vraska over one of the 3-mana Vivians, maybe.
I have a plan.
Speaking of Teferi,
Here we go.
Yeah, I could see a third Command the Dreadhorde instead of the Liliana Dreadhorde General. I don't know if you really need Liliana Dreadhorde General at all.
I will fight for my friend. I will not stop.
Let's try this.
Set.
Those who cannot perceive beyond the veil of light. I have just the trick for this.
Come on, draw a land, please. We really want to draw a land, play this Nissa, and be able to, like, kill Teferi and then play Spyglass. Maybe I kill Narset and then play Spyglass. No, don't do that. No. That's really unfortunate. No, I was saying you don't need Liliana Dreadhorde General, not Command the Dreadhorde. There. OJ. All these Dreadhorde cards. They kept a card on top. Cat.
I will rid you of corruption.
Cat. I'm going with the other Teferi. I'm not really that scared of that Teferi that's right there.
No, I am not making this up as I go.
So I did that testing to see if I was hoping they were going to use the cast down on the Wild Growth Walker first, and then I'd be able to act, you know, make my Spyglass a creature. But I'm not going to do that with the cast down in hand.
I got this.
Yeah, that looks pretty good there, Donahoe. Nissa.
I will protect the virtue of this world.
This land's gonna die.
The land fights for us.
Yeah, I can't really use Karn's tick-up ability and make the spyglasses creatures, yeah, because it is till our next turn. That is just too risky.
I was not prepared for this.
Evil cannot withstand a righteous army.
This might be a bad idea.
So what do I want to get with this card this time? Do I want the thing that makes their spells cost two more? Do I want the seven mana? Do I want Meteor Golem? Maybe Crucible.
Curiosity and
yeah, Narinen, absolutely.
Civilization, not. Secrets manifest before you.
So I feel like there's going to be a Kaya's Wrath come in this next turn, so I'm not going to make any... I'm not going to make a creature land with Nissa. Alright, well now I will.
Shall conquer you.
I am not threatened by you.
Oh, I've done the hero thing before.
Heed my instruction and prepare for war.
Our lands dying a bunch isn't really too big of a deal, considering we have a Crucible we get to go get.
Awaken.
Hmm.
The fabric of the multiverse obeys me.
Behold, nature's true power.
All right, we'll just get Teferi out of here so they don't get to bounce a spyglass with Teferi.
That didn't go according to plan.
You face somebody playing Nexus? I mean, that's for how you have your deck, you're not going to be beating Nexus, honestly. You have to have a lot more, need a lot more enchantment removal, you know, like Knight of Autumns kind of thing.
Your corpse will make
to start with. Need more like duresses, a faster clock. I mean, you'd have to change the deck a ton to try to help with that matchup. I think you just kind of punt that matchup. It's going to be just really hard for you to beat that.
I've learned much from your death.
Every day is a new lesson.
Can I tick up Nissa one more time before I ultimate? It's the main question. And I think that answer is yes.
Be wary of the ground you walk on.
I will not lose another friend. Let us begin.
Yes, Esper Hero is very good. I do want to pop the Silent Gravestone before I have like a lot of lands in the graveyard. This is the graveyard have hexproof symbol thing right there. That's kind of cool. All right, so let's crack this.
I can help you.
We will meet again.
You are a mighty warrior.
Before, so we're getting rid of one forest in the graveyard for and the other two forests in there.
Life cannot be denied.
All right, no more drawn forests for us. We're gonna mill out. I should have ticked up Ugin first, but that's fine. We'll just take this Branchwalker there.
Ether itself serves me.
Oh, say hello to my little friend.
So I can just go grab another Crucible. I'll make that a creature to hit them, like with this God Pharaoh statue, making them lose a life every turn. You know, we need to pressure them and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, I know the statue would be a 6/6, but I really don't want the statue to die. We'll have the statue be a 6/6 for like final killing them kind of thing. Okay. Narnan says I climbed the entirety of Diamond yesterday with a weird 5-color Vanifar deck yesterday, with 75 cards main deck. I don't know if that is because the deck is good or has a million answers. The mana is kind of bad, and that seems to be the biggest struggle with the deck. Yeah, send it my way, Narnan, and I'll see what I can do to help. What does our opponent have over here? Have you seen the new red enchantment that costs one red and says lands in your hand have cycling red? And you can cycle the enchantment for two. I have not seen that. I think our opponent is just like waiting for us to play more things, and they're just assuming, you know, they're just gonna say that they're dead.
Some solutions must be built.
I don't think they're actually fighting back right now. They just want to see more cards, kind of thing. No? Okay. Never mind. They're fighting back. All right. It's kind of crazy, all these cards, and we haven't seen any
manifest before you.
Didn't see any Field of Ruins at all. Hey, what's up, Ross? Thanks for that resub there. That Twitch Prime resub there. Thank you very much. Getting those hype in the chat. But yeah, so I know that cycling card's for Modern. It's really pretty interesting. I hadn't seen that card before. But it has cycling itself, and it gives all your land cycling. I don't know. I know there is some other cycling stuff in the set, like the lands, like Tranquil Thicket, or is it Tranquil Expanse? Whatever that whole cycle of cycling lands. I don't know. I could see that having an impact on Modern. You know, turning, you know, just spending one mana to get rid of lands and try to draw gas is certainly valuable. You hit Mythic with Boros Feather yesterday, going 14-6. Way to go! Awesome. All right, so we're playing against Esper Control. So I want Vivian. And I don't want Wild Growth Walker. And then is that it? Do I keep, like, spyglasses and that kind of stuff are good. Do I keep them in the sideboard to only grab from Karn, or do I put them in the main deck? I'm going to put one spyglass main over a crucible. So I still have one crucible and one spyglass in the sideboard. Or, I mean, I'll have two crucibles now. I don't know. Keeping them... I mean, we had to have Karn resolve to get spyglass and then spyglass resolve. No, I'll just keep it the same. Let's keep them in the sideboard. Yeah, Unearth. Yeah, Unearth is pretty good. That's a good card for sure. Yeah, we're playing four Field of Ruin with Crucibles here in this deck. Yeah, we have a few options in the sideboard, but not just a ton. Yeah, I've always liked land destruction decks too. That's what I play the Green White Company in Modern, got to destroy so many lands with Ghost Quarter. Yes, you're supposed to use Spyglass for Planeswalkers. That's the really obvious cards to use as Spyglass for Planeswalkers.
I will defend my allies.
This is neither. I'm not doing ranked, but these are not donation decks either. These are some lists that found online that, like, they've done well recently that I wanted to try out. Well, let's go ahead and see if the spyglass resolves. Big Teferi. I'm not going to attack with the Paradise Druid, so that if they play little Teferi, they can't just bounce Paradise Druid. A lot of considerations here. I don't. Could just go with getting the Crucible Worlds in play. Could just, like, activate Blast Zone up to two. The problem is we're not really activating Blast Zone up to three. Or like Blast Zone at 3 could destroy the Othakaya and the Teferi and try to do that before we play Crucible. But going with the Wild Growth Walker, so if they want to bounce...
I am not going to sit this one out.
Spyglass, then we'll be able to kill Teferi back. Okay, they're just going to bounce that.
I've got it.
So I could have this... I could use the Spyglass to kill Teferi, but don't really want to do that.
Awaken.
So I can put two counters on Blast Zone. I think that's what I do.
Here goes nothing.
My turn.
There are greater.
Hey, Prugor, good afternoon. All right, so they're just getting Teferi in play. They can't do anything with it right now.
You just let me know if you're up for round two.
They got a Kaya's Wrath and a random card. Thought Erasure. Well, they got a lot of good ones over here. I mean, it's got to be Karn or Ugin, right, that they're going to be taking. All right, down goes Karn. We certainly want to find Field of Ruin so that we can Field of Ruin with Crucible each turn. Like, that's the card that we want to find, especially how they surveilled and kept the card on top. I would love to draw Field of Ruin here. No Field of Ruin there. Maybe we'll find a Field of Ruin here. Nope.
Time for plan B.
Kasmina.
I'm brilliant, so do try to keep my students are loyal geniuses.
So they have to discard either Kaya's Wrath or the other card. Yeah, the Blast Zone has been awesome for us, honestly. It was like the only reason why we beat Mono Red earlier. Narset.
If you wish to surrender now, hone your prowess.
Not as effective We know to play around it.
Such violence is upsetting.
Of course, they can just cycle away the spell pierce, though, here.
My students are loyal.
And it did slow me down for a turn of not playing the Ugin. Oh, my opponent didn't have blue mana last turn? Wow. I didn't look at that. They just had a black-white land. Well.
Regardless, I have learned much.
Oh, well.
Recklessness and fear.
The fabric of the multiverse obeys me.
Oh, well. Still playing around that spell pierce perfectly. All right, mono green Tron is 4-0. This deck's sweet. So that means we're at the final boss. So, sorry, pumpkins. Time to get our final boss playlist out. Our playlist for whenever we do face our final boss. Will this deck be as good? Will this deck as it is be good at best of one? When you're playing best of one with a deck, you need to change your sideboard should just all be artifacts. You know, you just change your sideboard to all be artifacts and not have any other cards in your sideboard at all. Because it's, you know, best of one, you only need your sideboard just for Karn. So you get to play, like, three. Like, the main deck is good. But sideboard-wise, you get, like, a whole bunch more, you know, like, three or four spyglasses, honestly. Even main deck, you probably need it to be a little better against... You probably need your deck to be a little bit better against mono-red main deck. Like maybe having a couple of those Ripjaw Raptors main. Maybe like instead of this Adventurer's Impulse, you play a Ripjaw Raptor kind of thing. I think this mono red matchup would be the one I'm most worried about. Where's Wild Growth? I should play Blast Zone here. Yeah, I should just play Blast Zone and got a counter on it. Yeah, I should just play Blast Zone Pass. Since we drew another land. I don't know, maybe I don't need to do that. Certainly just... Never mind, I kind of like this. I'm just digging for Wild Growth Walker that I want on turn 5. I want to be able to play Wild Growth plus Jade Light together on turn 5. But obviously we have to find... a Wild Growth Walker first. Hey, whoa, Nine Baller! Thank you so much for that donation there. Alright, so what do we have here? Alright, let's, Alright, come on, Streamlabs. Load, I'll see what you're... What we got for our donation deck there. Thought I'd try to make a Naya version of the old Esper Blink deck. Feel free to change it. Sideboard could probably be better. Okay. We're going with a Naya Blink. Okay. That looks pretty nice. So Nineballer, what day do you want me to play it and what time? When would you like me to play that deck? All right, let's get Ripjaw in. So what did we do last time? So I took out Karn and Crucible completely. The Silent Dart, it just costs way too much mana. I'm not even gonna play it. I guess I'm gonna play Meteor Golem instead. Even though it costs 7. This is just not... Silent Dart's pretty bad. So yeah, like I have another donation deck for tomorrow as well. So like tomorrow's a real good day for that. And you can play it first, second, third, fourth. Oh, skip the line? Yeah. Yep. You can do the skip the line. Absolutely. So we'll just move Sultai Control. We're going to move that to tomorrow. So then up next, Naya Blink. Hey, Isop Sun. Hope work is going good today. Spyglass doesn't work with Steamkin because Steamkin's ability adds mana to the mana pool, and Steamkin's and Spyglass does not stop abilities that add mana to the mana pool. So Spyglass doesn't help here. The things we could Spyglass is we could Spyglass Fanatical Firebrand. And we could Spyglass Experimental Frenzy so they don't get to just destroy their Frenzy. So the only reason not to play more Paradise Druids is because of Chain Whirler. Yeah, I'm just going to pass this turn. I'm not playing a Wild Growth Walker because of the Chandra's Triumph. Hey, what's up, Dirk? All right, yeah. Nine Baller, that may be better also. Yeah, that could be better, honestly. Not bad.
I'll protect that which cannot protect itself. Harness the elements.
All Okay, so I'll get you tomorrow then, so I can really like take a look and see about tuning it and everything tomorrow. Peace. We'll go back to Soul Tide Control. Yep, perfect. Second tomorrow. Perfect. So we could just sack Firebrand and shoot a Paradise Druid. They get to block a forest, sack, kill a Paradise Druid. That's all right. I think I'm just trying to be real aggressive here. Probably putting more counters on this blast zone than just the two. So let me get this. So Naya Blink. That's like twice now. My lights have like flickered off and on. I don't know if that's. Nah, that wouldn't have been like the two bulbs. That'd be like my power. Is like my power like close to going out? I don't know. Yeah, I do have a storm headed this way. Actually, I can hear it. Like I can hear the thunder in the background. So if they play some more twos, then I'll pop blast zone. We'll kind of see what we have here. Tomorrow, seconds. Okay.
You and I are gonna take them out. Let's light it.
That should be game. So looks like we're going to a game three. These extra forests to attack.
Behold nature's true power.
All right, good job, Nissa. It'd be tough to fit Karn's Bastion in the deck. I mean, it had to be over. I don't even know what. You definitely need the 17 forests. I don't think you can take out a forest. I think you need 17 green sources. So I think to fit a Karn's Bastion in the deck, you would have to just like take out like Adventurous Impulse and just add in a 26th land. I think that's where you'd have to fit that in. No, you really want all your Field of Ruins in this deck. This is certainly a really good Field of Ruin deck. You'd play more if you could. And the Blast Zones have been awesome. I wouldn't recommend taking those out. But I could see just playing a 26th land in the deck. Alright, let's try to get to this Ripjaw Raptor right away. Certainly worried about Chain Whirler on 3. So normally I would be playing other mana creatures, but I really don't want Chain Whirler to wreck me. By playing Wild Growth Walker 2, that incentivizes our opponent to use, yeah, like a Lightning Strike or whatever on the Wild Growth Walker, which means no Chain Whirler for Llanowar Elf. Oh no!
They have Firebrand too.
Well, that just didn't work out. Please don't have Chain Whirler. Please don't, please don't. Alright, blocking here to save 4 life, plus if they do have Chain Whirler, which is kind of seems like it. Like, if they want to remove counters from Steamkin, and it just kills the Steamkin now. They don't get to play anything else this turn. Okay, they're killing the Steamkin.
You want to go, tough guy? What's that smell? Oh, it's you burning. Now you've done it. And watch it burn.
Dang it. Oh, that's a good one. That's also a good one. I guess they don't get to play the Tibalt now, but
no problem. Fire can't solve.
Still, that's Chandra's Triumph. The oh no. No, now they get to play Tibalt. Oh, man, or Chain Whirler. But wow, what a great turn for the opponent. That was the turn that won the game. Right there for sure. What a great turn.
Oh, they're so cute.
What can I do with this Blast Zone? Can blow up like 3s next turn. Yeah, that was a brutal. Blow up 3s, but how am I dealing with Steamkin and Chandra? I'm just not. I go Wild Growth. Plus Branch Walker, I don't gain life. That's not good for me either. Yeah, we're getting another match here.
This is just gonna be bad for you.
There you go. Yep, getting those 3/3 Field of Ruins and Crucibles. Yeah, this is a nice deck. That light up the stage to get the extra mana with Steamkin to play Tibalt and then also hit, you know, Chain Whirler too. That was just an absolutely brutal turn.
The more, the messier.
Okay. Well, we needed to draw a land there and play like Wildgrowth Walker to block and hope they had nothing. I guess I don't.
There's no problem fire can't solve.
And that's lethal. Red matchup's still pretty tough with having Blast Zone as our only removal spell. It's basically our only removal there. Alright, let's see what our opponent's doing. Hopefully Field of Ruin Crucible is really good against our opponent, you know, so hopefully they're playing like a slower deck with a lot of colors. That is not the case. No, Damping Sphere is not a good sideboard card against Burn. Well, if they don't have... If they don't have Chain Whirler, then we can Nissa next turn. Obviously, they do have Chain Whirler. I can't beat that card. Well, I have six cards I want to take out, and then like four cards I want to bring in. So I guess I'm going to play a couple Force Landings with us seeing Rekindling Phoenix, because I'll play that over Vivian. Still have Ugin's to destroy Frenzies. Let's try that. Hey, Ganja. Okay, so if Adventurous Impulse can find Jadelight, there we go. So we'll see. So obviously they know that we're going to have the Jadelight Ranger, so they're going to be really prioritizing killing this Wildgrowth Walker on turn two, but we're still going to play it here on turn two. Hey, Ludacris. This will keep them from killing me this turn. Can't just like slam down Steamkin, for example. Now they gotta kill this Wildgrowth Walker also, so they don't get to just like Chain Whirler or Steamkin again. Really slowing them down a bunch. So that's Wizard's Lightning. No Wizard's Lightning. Well then. Well then. So they bolt Jade Light and attack me. But then I play Ripjaw, attack them back. All right, this is looking good for us. But can we get game three? That's the big question. My Wild Growth Walker, no. Well, you did your job. Yeah, like, I don't even know, like, Rekindling Phoenix would be, like, their best card to draw, I guess? So they have Light up the stage? No.
Ether itself serves me.
Okay. Game three. That's where we lost last time against Red. It was game three. On the draw, we'll see if we can get one here. The forced landings are just really awkward against, you know, it's only good against specifically Rekindling Phoenix, but we kind of need it, because otherwise we're not going to be beating Rekindling Phoenix at all. Yeah, usually in the Mythic, percentages-wise, what I've kind of noticed is that each match you win, you gain, like, 1%. So if you're at, like, 90%, if you win a match, you go to 91%. You win a match, you go to 92%, and so on. Lose a match, you go back down 1%. That's not a, you know, it's not a perfect metric, but it's around that. It's a good estimate. Please no Chain Whirler. Please no Chain Whirler. Let me untap and Ripjaw or Wild Growth or go Walker Walker. Please, no Chain Whirler. Okay, that's not a Chain Whirler. Let's do this. Let's double spell. Assuming the Paradise Druid's gonna die to a Firebrand also. Get us closer to another forest. Pass turn. Ooh. Let us keep the Paradise Druid. Very nice. And do we get to keep the Paradise Druid for another turn? Wow, that's lucky. So, of course, I want to do this before tapping the Paradise Druid. I don't want them to be able to block with Firebrand and then shoot Paradise Druid. So we need to go to attackers first. Ooh. Okay, they're going to Lightning Strike this and double block it. Or I guess they could just shock it. Well, yeah, so they didn't even need to block with the Firebrand. Because the Lava Runner is a 2-2 now. That was the waste of a Firebrand. Could have killed my Paradise Druid earlier. Glad they didn't.
Seek shelter in my stewardship. Harness the elements. Bum, 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 bum.
This is looking good for us.
Do not underestimate my fortitude. The land fights for us.
More lands, please.
You destroy my patience.
Do we want to play this Ugin?
The land shall conquer you.
Nope, we're attacking. I mean, I guess I can still play Ugin. Alright, looks like we're going to be 5-1 after this. There we go. No, I didn't miss lethal. I mean, we couldn't play Ugin and just kill a blocker and still attack with all those 3/3s. Where's our victory fanfare? There we go. 5-1 went 2-1 against red decks. Pretty good showing there. Yeah, this deck was a lot of fun. Really liked this deck. Like, just playing, you know, like Karn, Nissa, Ugin, especially Ugin. Like, those are definitely some fun cards. Karn grabbing all these cards from the sideboard, like the artifacts from the sideboard, was really sweet. I think Silent, like, what I would change, I don't think Silent Dart's a playable card. Like, I don't think this card's any good at all, like, against anything. I would not I would not recommend playing this card. I would certainly just take that card out. And then I think we just want another Spyglass. There's just a bunch of planes, like really, really planeswalker heavy decks. And just honestly, having three Spyglasses would be pretty nice. So I would just want a third Spyglass in the sideboard to be able to get with the Karn. Against like those Esper decks and everything. So there we go. That's the one little change that I would make for the next time playing it. the artifact that gives -1/-0 to tokens. I don't think you really need that card. That would be good against like Hero of Precinct 1. I don't know if you really need that card. Nah. We never drew a Force Landing. I like the idea of Force Landing though. Flyers are going to be a problem for this deck, and especially like Arclight Phoenix gets rid of it really well. I could see playing like Crushing Canopy instead if there's more Nexus in your metagame, playing Crushing Canopy instead to be able to have some more utility. But this is really good against both Phoenixes, Rekindling and Arclight, and Gruul decks and Is It Phoenix decks are both, you know, kind of popular. And so having a card that deals with the Phoenixes one for one is really nice. Yeah, Helm of the Host is really that, like, Helm of the Host, honestly, I could see playing a Helm of the Host over the third Spyglass, honestly. Helm of the Host is really nice. And like there's games with Nissa and everything. Maybe just do that. Maybe just play another, like, just play Helm of the Host. Like, you can get enough mana, especially with like Ugin making it cost less. And putting this card on God Pharaoh Statue, on Meteor Golem, even on like Jade Light Ranger, for example, when you have a Wild Growth Walker in play. Putting it on Spyglass, you know, like making a new Spyglass kind of thing. I don't know, maybe just play a Helm of the Host. Maybe not. It's worth a try though. Like, I've definitely done that with like Statue or Golem before. Of course, you know, you have to make the statue a creature, and then you equip the Helm of the Host to the statue after it's a creature, and so on. Maybe a third Spyglass. You know, this is a card you can try out if you want, but Spyglass is a good one. I wouldn't mind. Even like, I guess he could have an Immortal Sun also, but then, you know, that would shut down our main cards here, like our 12 main cards. But Immortal Sun does just kind of just wreck some decks. All right, if you're watching this video later on YouTube, hope you enjoyed it. And please hit that like and subscribe buttons over there.